Hi, Happy New Year, everybody, and welcome to Things in My Head. I'm Angel Birch, your host. I can't believe that it's 2014 already. Can you? This is crazy. It seems like just yesterday we were bringing in 2013. But 2014 is going to be a great year here at Things in My Head. In fact, we're starting off this whole month of January talking about New Year's resolutions. Do you always make a New Year's resolution and have a hard time keeping it? Well, that's why this month we're going to be talking to some experts on health and wellness, fitness and nutrition, getting back to family, getting back into church, things like that. We're going to be talking about all of those things, make those New Year's resolutions about and have a hard time keeping them. So hopefully this year we're going to have a little bit better time keeping them. Stay tuned today because we are going to be kicking off that series with Paul Dean, who is an expert in essential oils. In fact, I have a little secret to tell you, but you're going to have to wait till after this to hear it. We'll be right back. Bridgeport Lake Bed and Breakfast outside Dallas, Texas can give you the perfect intermission of warmth and lake activities. From the long-stem chocolate rose on your pillow at check-in to the made-to-order breakfast each morning, you'll leave your stress behind and immerse yourself in unparalleled Texas hospitality. Bridgeport Lake Bed and Breakfast. For reservations, call 940-644-0081 or visit us on the internet at www.bridgeportlakebnb.com. And we're back with Paul Dean from Rocky Mountain Oils. Paul, how are you doing?
Doing great, thank you.
Awesome. So, okay, essential oils. This is like one of the biggest movements in the United States at the moment. Everywhere you go on the internet, everyone you talk to is either buying, selling, multi-level marketing, or using essential oils and wanting to know more information about it. Why?
Well, it all stems from the going back to organic and improving your health movement that started in the 60s, in the 70s, and slowly but surely it starts growing and growing and growing. And the baby boomers are now in the stage in their life that they're realizing that the pharmaceutical drugs aren't working, the doctors aren't working. Let's go for other alternatives.
And it's so expensive to go to the doctor. Just one time going to the doctor, you walk in the door, they want to charge you $200, you know?
It is. It does get a lot more expensive than versus buying something natural that you can get quick, fast, easy results from.
Okay, before we go into the results, I want you to let my listeners know what makes you an expert in this field, because we've told our listeners all week that we have an expert in essential oils. But I haven't told you a little secret about Paul. He's not just an expert in essential oils. He's also a real-life Indian medicine man. And that is part of what makes him an expert here, because he has studied the oils right down to the natural level. Paul, what makes you an expert in this field?
My whole background, I was raised up with the philosophy that we have everything on this planet to keep us healthy and happy. I mean, my mother started a health food store in Tennessee back in the 70s, and I grew up with the philosophy that we can take care of our own health. And it was about 30 years ago was my first introduction to the essential oils. My grandfather came to me. I had a cold sore on my lip. And I was getting these cold sores about once every 6 months. And my grandfather came to me and says, Paul, here's an oil that the Aboriginals use over in Australia. They put on this, it's called tea tree, and they just put it on the cold sores or any other sores and it'll heal it up. And so I got the bottle and I applied it quite heavily. Every hour I'd put a drop on right on my cold sore and it would burn for about 30 to 60 seconds and then it would numb it up and it would, you know, feel good and go dead. But what was interesting, it was instead of my cold sore forming like it would normally form, it went away. And now it's been over 30 years and I haven't had a cold sore since.
Well, do you think maybe that's just something that people grow out of, though, really?
Well, it's all virus related. You know, the cold sores are virus related. And if you turn around and you kill the virus or you build up your immune system, you know, it'll eradicate it. We've had lots and lots and lots of other people who have used this for that, and it gets rid of it.
Okay, getting back to why you're an expert.
Okay, I started learning about herbs and learning about this. I discovered that the essential oils are like super concentrated herbs. They are extracts, the volatile components of the herbs that can be hundreds of thousands of times stronger. Normally, there's about 2-3% essential oil in an herb. And in the olden days, you know, they would go out and pick the fresh herbs and use them and you would get powerful results. Well, nowadays people are shopping for the dried herbs in the stores and they're not getting the results that their grandparents was. The reason being is the dried herb does not contain the essential oil. So in 1997, I quit my job that I was doing, moved my family, and we went to work for the top essential oils experts in the world there. They were supposedly providing the highest quality therapeutic best oils in the market. After a year of seeing what they were doing versus what they said they were doing, I decided to leave and start doing it all myself.
Well, from what I understand, after testing their product, you actually found out that their oil was not pure. Is that true?
Correct. There's different types of adulteration. You know, you can mix natural components together, like two different batches of lavender from different farms. But it came down to it. The straw that broke the camel's back was them using synthetic, harmful, toxic, cancer-causing chemicals in with the essential oils to try to make them smell better, and selling them out as 100% pure to their customers.
Please tell me that company is not in business anymore.
they still are.
Uh-oh.
And it comes down to, because I was so shocked, I came home and I said, look, if I'm going to go out and find and use the oils for the rest of my life because I want to do that, I'm going to have to go and do it myself and make sure what I'm getting is actually what I'm paying for.
Right. Right. Well, this company is still in business. Can they do that? Isn't that false advertising?
Well, here's how funny the laws are. In the United States right now, 3% of pure essential oil mixed with 97% of some other chemical, you know, propylene glycol is a major one that's out there, they can still label it and call it as 100% pure. That's how silly the laws are. And how I came about that is in 1998, I was wondering why an essential oil from a health food store could be sold so cheaply. I knew what I was buying it for directly from the farm growing it, and they were selling it for a lot cheaper than I could buy it for. So I grabbed a bottle, I sent it off to the lab to be tested. It came back as 75% propylene glycol, and on the label it said 100% pure, natural, you know, all the wonderful things you wanted. And that's when I went in and started looking at the laws. And because there is no grading system in the United States with essential oils and no real quality control, I mean, everybody's out there saying that they've got the best oils, they've got the best oils, they've got the best.
Well, we've also heard that there's a grading system here. I mean, how can sites actually say our oils are graded therapeutic or our oils are A, B, C? I mean, I actually read a site that broke down this A, B, C and therapeutic and pharmaceutical and all of that, and they swore up and down that their oils were therapeutic.
Well, it comes down to it. It's a great marketing strategy, marketing hype there. They might break it down, but really there's no such thing. I mean, on our website, you'll see that it will say therapeutic grade essential oils because that's what people are used to realizing that that's what high quality is. But if you go and you test our oils with the top therapeutic grade essential oil companies out there, we're 50% quality improved right there. It's much like the car industry. Even though the cars have four wheels and a steering wheel, there's a major difference between an economy car and a, you know, high-end exotic sports car. And that's what we deal in. We really deal in the high-end, high-quality oils that people are already used to using essential oils, and now they want the best. They want the most for their money.
Okay, but they work.
Yes. And what's interesting is even the low-end oils will work. Just because the essential oils are so powerful, even if you get one that's highly diluted, you're still going to find out that it works, and it works, you know, quite well.
So but, why buy a more expensive oil or a more pure oil if the lower-end quality works?
Well, it's simply because, like the car, you know, why buy the exotic sports car? Well, you can get to your place that you want to get going in a quicker manner. Like oregano, most people who go to the store and buy oregano, that's been adulterated with most likely olive oil or other things. And our oregano oil, one bottle would be the equivalent of maybe 50 bottles of the other person's oregano oil.
So in using your oils, potentially we'd be using a lot less.
Yes, correct. You'll use a lot less and you'll get better results.
Wow. Okay, now the proof is in the pudding, Paul. So if someone were to ask you to have those chemical testing papers, these whatever they call them, would you be willing to provide them?
Yes, we do. We, as a standard, if someone asks places an order, we'll provide up to two tests that they ask for on there. If they want a whole lot more, because of the time frame, we just say $10 a test. But I would just suggest, you know, buy two oils, get two tests, buy two oils, get two other tests. The real thing comes down to it is, despite all the marketing hype and everything, those tests are quite meaningless.
Oh.
they're meaningful to us when we go and look at the synthetic chemicals and other things, but it's meaningless in the sense of they don't really explain if an oil's been adulterated, because the chemistry experts are so good at their job, they can fool the testing people. They do it all the time. One of my French contacts over there, he says, you know, it's only when we get sloppy with our adulteration that they pick it up as being adulterated. But he says, we can make you any oil that you want in any way you want it, and it'll pass off as pure. For example, lavender 4042 that's being sold on almost all the websites, you know, out there.
And that seems to be a standard when you ask.
Yeah, and people will say, oh, lavender 4042, this is our best seller, or all this. People don't realize that's 95% synthetic, 5% pure. That's the industry standard. If you want to buy a lavender 4042, I know that it's 5% pure, 95% synthetic, but people are selling it pure all the time. And it's just amazing that that's what's going on.
Now, you speak of lavender. Now, I have some of your lavender, and I also have another brand's lavender, a very popular brand's lavender, because I have a friend of mine who actually markets that. And in smelling the two, and I think you and I had talked about this over the phone recently, and smelling the two, your lavender smelled like I was walking through a lavender field. The other lavender smelled more like, honestly, it smelled a lot like if I were burning an aromatherapy candle. And it didn't have that. I don't know what it is about the smell that made it so different, other than I can say that it was a deeper smell. It was a richer smell. It smelled like the actual herb. It smelled like real lavender.
And that's what we really try to specialize in. There's lots of ways you can go and extract the oils for that. And what we try to specialize in is extracting the oil for the most healing therapeutic properties, the most beneficial properties. For example, peppermint. Peppermint, normally by 99% of peppermint out there, is distilled under high pressure, high temperature, to try to get as much peppermint as you can from the plant, and you'll get a really sharp, crisp peppermint smell. Well, that sharp, crisp peppermint smell is a more lower quality peppermint. The way we do our peppermint is we actually do it in three rounds of distillation. We'll distill it first with no added pressure, and we'll get a peppermint that's kind of quite herby smelling. And that's what we consider the first distilled peppermint, and that's the best therapeutic. And then we'll turn around and distill it again for the flavor and the fragrance aspects of the nice, sharp, crisp peppermint. But we very much try to go in and extract the oils for their healing properties.
I'm looking at a peppermint that I bought from another company. I'm not going to tell you the name of this company. However, it is a popular brand. And it says the extraction method is steam distilled from aerial parts, and in parentheses it says leaves.
Leaves, yes, but here's the funny thing. You know, you get 1,000 acres of peppermint out there, you're not going to go in and have hire people to hand pick off the leaves and throw them in there. What they're going to do is they're going to cut down the whole stalk, throw it in there. So really, right there, right off the bat, I know that they're not being true with their marketing. Just because unless you hand pick off the leaves and do your own batch in your own kitchen or in your own laboratory, all peppermint is distilled with the stalk and the leaves.
Oh.
And the other thing is, if you probably smell that peppermint, it's probably going to smell nice and sharp and crisp peppermint.
I'm smelling it, if you guys are wondering what I'm doing. So, it does. It smells like peppermint candy.
Yeah, exactly. And that's high pressure, steam distilled peppermint right there. That's what I would consider food grade or soap grade peppermint. That's not what I would consider high quality peppermint oil.
What does your peppermint smell like? How is it different?
It's herby. You're gonna smell the herbiness to it, and especially when we get it right out of fresh from the distiller. We just got our new harvest in, and it is very herby. And what we try to do is let it sit for a little bit, so that herbiness will calm down. But But even after several years, you're still going to smell the herbiness. You'll smell it and you'll have those herby undertones right there.
I can hear the gears in my listeners' minds turning. Yes, I will get some of this and I will let you know if there's a difference. We'll keep updating on our Facebook page. We'll be back with Baldine from Rocky Mountain Oils right after this.
Guess what I just did? I just saved 80% on my grocery bill. Yep. Walked right into the store with my coupons and saved 80% at the checkout. Want to know how I did it? I went to couponcoachlisa.com and became a member for just $5. Coupon Coach Lisa has easy-to-follow tutorial videos that showed me step-by-step how to get the most savings for my grocery dollar. Oh, and this is not just a one-time thing either. CouponCoachLisa.com has taught me how to do this every time I go shopping. I've saved so much money by joining CouponCoachLisa.com. Now I can even go on a date with my husband. Get connected, stay connected with CouponCoachLisa.com.
By the way, right now, what's your webpage?
Oh, RockyMountainOils.com.
Okay, so we want to go to RockyMountainOils.com, and we're going to take a look at all of Paul's oils.
Yes, and here's what comes down to it. The more you use the oils, the more your nose is going to become attuned to what is actually good and not. What we really specialize in is working with the small farms. We go and we deal with the small farms all around the world. That number one, that's going to improve the quality, because that's the big difference between growing a tomato in your own backyard versus going down to the local grocery store and picking a tomato. The average person, if they're first starting out, they may not like the pure oil. They think, oh, this is herby, or oh, this is too intense, or this is too strong. For example, when I'm teaching about the essential oils, I'll go out and pass around the pure rose oil, and then I'll pass around a rose oil that's been diluted 98% with a carrier oil, and I'll ask people to vote on what smell they like best. 90% of the people will vote that they like the oil that's been diluted 98%, you know, the less strong oil versus the pure. So when you first start out, you might have a hard time understanding quality, but as you go, you'll be able to pick it up right off the bat and you'll go, wow.
All right. So I've got the lavender, and we've got several of them over here on the counter. And the second I take the lid off of this oil, and I can tell you there's not a whole lot left in this bottle. It's almost residue because I've used all of it. But the second I take the lid off of it, I can smell that lavender. It's instantaneous. I didn't even have it near my nose and I could smell this. And that to me says that there's either you've added enhancers to the fragrance of this, or this is some pretty powerful stuff. The average listener here is probably going to go to the health food store or even buy something online. They're going to smell it. And can they really tell? I mean, I can tell with the lavender, and like I said, the peppermint smells just like peppermint candy, but unless they get it side by side, are they really going to be able to tell the difference? I mean, you're talking about people who are willing to spend $50 to $100 on an oil.
Oh, yeah. And we keep track of what other companies are doing. And let me just put it this way. I'm not intimidated by what they're doing because I know what I'm doing.
Yeah. I've not been into the essential oils for very long, about 2 years. Guys, I was one of those people that bought into the hype. I went to one of the largest oil distributors and bought from them. I know people who sell them. They are a multi-level marketing company, even though they don't say they are, but they are. I bought from a friend and I said, wow, you know, I've got essential oils and I'm getting into them and all this. And then I came across Paul and his site. Now, you know me. Those of you who listen to me on a regular basis, I do not promote different products unless I feel good about that particular product. I'm not going to give you a promotion of a product that I don't believe in or that I don't feel good about. I took Paul's oils side by side and tried them. One of the things that we did was we tested your immune strength with another brand, comparable blend of another brand, which you have on your site, which I thought was really cool. You actually have the names of the other brands, and then you have what's comparable on your site. And we did that, and the immune strength that I used from your site made me feel better quicker than my husband, who has a great immune system.
You know, that immune strength there formula, you know, a lot of ours, we'll try to go around and make up some blends that are quite similar to what people are used to using because they like using them in there. But we always try to go out and enhance or improve them in some way, shape, or form, not only using the better oils. I'll give you an example. Oregano. Most people are used to using oregano, but they're used to using, you know, French oregano or European oregano, which has a chemical The main chemical is carvacrol, and that's about 40%. Where our oregano, we've got a village who goes out and handpicks the oregano, and we distill it right there. Our carvacrol level on this last batch was, I think, 80.1%. It's twice as strong, twice as powerful. And so you'll be able to notice it.
Wow. Now, oregano is considered a hot oil. What? Why would it be a hot oil?
Hot oil is, if you put it on your skin is going to get hot, red, burny, and even blister. That oregano, for example, you put it on your skin, it's going to start feeling like you're getting burnt right there, and it'll even cause a burn blister. So you want to always be really careful with the pure oils and start out slow. Mix them with a carrier oil, you know, put 4 or 5 drops of a carrier oil to 1 drop of pure oil, and then test it out on your body to see how you're going to respond.
Now, what's a good carrier oil? That's kind of a term that's not booted around at the dinner table.
Yes. The carrier oil is any vegetable oil you can use. If you're starting out, a lot of people would just grab, you know, extra virgin olive oil and use that. The olive oil is more greasy, but massage therapists, what they really like is we've discovered it's the fractionated coconut oil. That is an adulterated oil, meaning it's a fraction of the coconut oil. It's just the medium chain fatty acid esters from coconut oil. But the massage therapists love it because it feels so good. It's good internally, externally, and it doesn't stain their sheets and it doesn't have a smell. But really any type of, you know, almond oil, apricot, anything oil that you want that's high end, you can mix it with your essential oil.
Now, what about your blends on your site? Because I noticed a lot of them say that they are blended with fractionated coconut oil to help the blend.
Yes, some of our blends or a lot of our blends are already mixed, but you can always buy them in their pure form. So you can then go and mix them yourself. Like we made a copy of a blend there that people were used to using mixed. And so we still sell it mixed, but our massage therapist will buy it in the pure form and dump a 15 mil bottle in their 8 ounces of massage oil. And then they get to go mix it themselves. So we always have it in the pure form that you can go and mix it yourself if you want.
Now that brings up an interesting question. What is the shelf life of an essential oil? Is it safe to use it 2 or 3 years later, or is a year about it?
You can use it quite a lot later. You're going to hear lots of different answers. You go to the grower, they're going to say 1 year. Why? Because every year they got a new harvest. You go to another essential oils company, they'll say 2 or 3 years or 5 years and stuff. But through my learning, this is what it's come down to. For most essential oils, it's indefinite if you keep them in a sealed place out of the sun, you know, sealed, cooled place. Like frankincense, for example, will just keep improving with age and improve. But normally, the pressed citrus oils, we try to say there's a 3-year shelf life on the pressed citrus because they're pressed and there's little bits of peel and waxes in there that they can oxidize and go off. But really, it comes down to, I've had a bottle of pressed citrus, and it was 8 years old. It was actually lemon. I opened up that bottle after 8 years. I smelled it. I tasted it. I used it over the next 6 months, and it worked just as fine as when I first got it right from the pressing. So these oils like oregano, tea tree, lavender, I have not seen them go bad. And I basically tell them an indefinite shelf life.
Awesome. What can we use these things for? I mean, I've heard people say that they can use them for cleaning. They can use them for the therapeutic use, you know, getting rid of colds, cuts, things like that. What can they be used for, really? I mean, are we just fooling ourselves?
Oh, no. If you've got a problem, there's an oil that you can find out there that'll take care of that problem. One of my favorite essential oils is called helichrysum. It's helichrysum italicum. And the reason why I love that is over the last decade, that has saved me about $4,000 not taking myself, my friends, my family to the hospital and go get stitches. I'll give you an example. But my son was out there playing around with a machete he got from the tool shed, and I told him not to play with that. And I took it back and put it in the machete. Don't do this. Well, lo and behold, a couple hours later, he got it out, and he was all gung-ho.
He was being a boy.
Yeah, gung-ho about chopping down this tree with a machete, and he accidentally chopped his finger down to the bone, right across the knuckle.
Oh, no.
And, you know, and it was a good little gash there. And so what we did is brought him inside, put in a couple drops of helichrysum, put a popsicle stick on the bottom of his finger, bandaged it all up. The next day we took it off. Everything was all sealed up, and I had him bend his finger. I was expecting it to burst open. You know, I had him bend his finger there because it was right across the knuckle. It still was sealed right up. I pinched it a little bit, said, did that hurt? No. And I pinched it harder. Does that hurt? No. It was all better. Overnight, It was all better. I just put another drop of helichrysum on it, put a regular bandage on it, And then let him go at it. And, you know, a couple hours later, I look out the window and he's digging a hole to China and his bandage is off and he's all fun. But I have seen this time and time and time again, where literally you put a couple drops of helichrysum on a wound, look at it the next day, you'll have 2 weeks worth of healing happens overnight.
Wow. You have herbal supplements, which brings us into the fact that you are an Indian medicine man.
Yes, yes. What we did is we made up some wonderful supplement, for the most part using some Native American herbs. One of them in there is siaga. It's a phenomenal herb that will assist the immune system, assist in stem cells, assist in detoxification. It's powerful, and I could probably go on for hours talking about this, but I love this herb from the Native Americans. We do have some basic supplements. Of those supplements, defense is my number one. The reason being is it activates your body's own ability to find its own problems and heal itself. We have other things like enzymes and probiotics and greens to get that. And then, you know, Rice Plus, which is antioxidants and B vitamins and things like that. But we do have high quality supplements that don't have the fillers like maltodextrin or cornstarch, you know, the genetically modified stuff that they're putting into everything at the health food store nowadays. We keep it all pure and natural, and they work.
Well, I got another testimony here for you, and I haven't told Paul this. I have problems with my joints. Like I said before, autoimmune problems, that sort of thing. Now, a week ago when I talked to him on the phone, originally he had mentioned the defense, and I looked at it and I thought, you know, how can I justify spending another $34 to get this shipped to me? And in our household, we probably spend close to $100 a month in supplements, okay, between my husband and I. A lot of his supplements for joint and things like that, popular supplements that you would find it at the grocery store or the pharmaceutical counter, they don't work on me. I can take them all day long, and I don't get the results that he does. My joints still hurt. In fact, a lot of them upset my stomach because they have fillers like soy and things like that in them. Paul mentioned the defense, and I thought, do I dare? And I even said to you on the phone, I don't know if I can justify this, you know, spending this money to do this. But my husband said, you know what, try this one last thing, because you've tried everything on the market and it's not working. And he knows how miserable it is when you lay on your side at night and you can't sleep because your joints hurt, or, you know, you eat something and your stomach is sick. You know, you just kind of want to give up after a little while. Well, I did buy it. I've taken it. I have so much more energy. You know, I took last week off, guys, and I was so bored. I was like, oh my gosh, I thought I was going to sleep the whole time, but no way. I had so much energy, and that's not me. When I take time off, I am a couch potato. I mean, I'm telling you, I'm being honest with you here. But I took the defense, and after about 4 days, I was really seeing a big difference. Now, that's 2 pills a day. Now, I have a problem swallowing pills, so I actually have to open them up and take them with my food. And this has worked for me. I no longer have the joint pain at night. I can say that honestly. I have slept better in the last 3 nights than I have in the last 3 years. My body is starting to adjust to this. You know, I'm the type of person that if I don't know what it's doing to my body, I'm kind of leery about it. But I trusted Paul. I trusted his expertise. And I went ahead and bought this. And I can tell you, out of everything that I have tried over the last 3 years, this is the only thing that has worked. So he's got a customer for life as far as the defense is concerned. Now, there is a story that Paul told me, and this was one of the reasons why I decided to try this. Paul, you have a friend of yours that was battling something pretty serious.
Yes, how it was all brought to me here in the original thing was, well, gosh, this is quite some time ago, 15 plus years ago. My friend, he had stage 4 cancer. The doctors gave him just a few weeks left to live. I mean, he had colon cancer that metastasized to his bones, lymphatic system, throat, stomach, all over his body. And he literally had a couple weeks left to live. The doctors said, sorry, nothing else we can do. Go home and die. See you later. And he happens to have Native American blood in him. So he went back to his Native American roots and contacted his medicine man and said, basically, the white man can't do anything for me. Can you? The medicine man said, yes, eat this siaga. Just keep it in your mouth and eat it and eat it and eat it and eat it. And so he figured, well, I'm going to be dead in a couple weeks anyways. Might as well just do that and see what happens. Well, he started doing that and his cancer went into remission. You know, he stopped bleeding. He started feeling better and his cancer went into remission. And that got him so excited. He went out and became a naturopathic doctor and studied what was going on with this. And the siaga is the highest known natural source for bioavailable beta-glucans, which your people aren't going to know what they are, but it's vitamin C is the most natural researched product out there, natural product out there. Beta-glucans is number two. The reason why you don't hear about it is it because they're so expensive to get the bioavailable high quality. And it's also the highest known natural source for the mineral antioxidant, anti-cancer mineral germanium. And so we discovered this, and that's what we put in the defense.
Now, I want to make a disclaimer here because we are not saying that this is going to cure cancer. Okay, not in any way, shape, or form can we say that or can we make that claim. We're saying that this worked for this gentleman. It also, it does help you with some of your autoimmune problems, and I'm a testimony to that fact. And I will tell you that all day long that this has helped me when other products have not. But the siagi, first of all, it doesn't taste good. So I commend the guy for keeping it in his mouth for any length of time. So RockyMountainOils.com. I would recommend it even if you're feeling like you have a little bit of after Christmas depression, you know. Go ahead and get that, because I know as a mom, Christmas and Thanksgiving, all the holidays can really take that out of you. It can take a lot out of you dealing with the kids being home, you know, not being in school and that sort of thing, and you're cooking for everybody or you're going to visit everybody. It just really takes a lot out of your system. And as a mom, as a woman, we have a lot of issues with energy levels and hormones. And for a little while, we just get so wiped out and tired, we end up on the couch because we're tired. But I will recommend this. The defense is what you need. You need to go to RockyMountainOils.com and get the defense. Try it out. He's got, now, is there a guarantee with this defense? Because I didn't even look. Once it started working, I was like, woohoo!
Well, it comes down to it. You know, you have the 30-day money-back guarantee on all the products. Okay. You can send it back there. I've told people, if you don't like it, send it back. We'll refund your money. I mean, we have the best customer support in any industry.
We had, recently, you guys had sent out over the 12 days of Christmas on your newsletter, a lot of really good blend recipes for different things. And I have to admit, I loved it. I absolutely enjoyed that. And I found a lot of oils. I've made a list of oils that I don't have that I want to try that I would love to have in my arsenal. And I have quite a few, but I mean, unless you have your own pharmaceutical company or your own oil company like Paul does, I don't think you're going to have all of them at any given time. I think you're going to find your particular ones that you like. And you'll probably buy them over and over again. Like lavender, I'm constantly out of lavender. Paul, help me out here. I'm out of lavender all the time. What can we do for my listeners? I know, because they're doing the same thing. They're buying these oils that they like, and they're constantly out. How can we help them out?
Well, we're going to get you a link so you can put up on there, and we'll have even a special on that link there where your listeners can click on the link and for the next week be able to get some. We'll put lavender on there, get lavender at a special price there, and you know, probably a couple other oils. We'll go pick out some of our favorite oils and put them on there so your listeners can be able to go out there and buy them at a discount right now. And the blends there, they're a good way to start using the oils because they're formulated to perform a specific function. We have one for breathe easy for the respiratory system, you know, another one for the immune strength for the immune system and different things like that. So you can quickly look on the website and read about the oil and figure out what you need it for and use it. You know, the single oils are lovely and wonderful, but the blends are a quick, easy way to start using them and get results. Sign up for our newsletter because we'll blast out a newsletter saying, look, we've got 50 bottles of these and first come, first serve, you know?
Right. Yeah. And I love the fact that on your newsletter, you don't send out spam. You don't send out a newsletter every single day telling me, oh, you need to buy this, you need to buy this. It's always, you know, hey, we got a special buy, or hey, we got a new product in. You're not bombarding my inbox with a whole bunch of emails that I'm not going to read. I have read every single one of those emails that you guys have sent me, and every one of them have contained something that has been useful, some information that has been useful to me. Now, I want to put another disclaimer out there, guys. Those of you who know me that listen on a regular basis, you know that I do not fall with the hype. I'm one of these investigative reporters that will investigate things to the hilt to find out if it's good for you, good for me. If I'm not going to give it to my family, I'm not going to promote it to give to your family. I'm not that type of person. And I'm telling you that I have compared these oils and the benefits of having the Rocky Mountain oils in my home. My husband was the biggest skeptic. He was one of those people that was, well, that's your thing. That's you. And when I started doing the experimenting, I said, baby, I need you to help me just to experiment for the show. He is so convinced that these oils work. I will tell you a secret. My husband had a very bad staph infection. It had produced lesions on his ear, which is very close to the brain and very, very dangerous. And over the holidays, you can't get in to see the doctor. There's just, you know, it's almost next to impossible. But we happened to have some frankincense and we had immune strength. Now, I know that frankincense, after reading, it does help keep staph at bay. And so I said, well, we're going to put this in honey. We're going to give it to you as a supplement. We're also going to put it on your ear. We're going to keep this stuff at bay until we can get to a doctor, because I'm not sure how to treat this completely with the oils, but you know, we need to keep this at bay. And in putting the oils on his ear, we went to the doctor. He got an antibiotic and a cream, and he said, okay, I'm good now. He said, we don't have to put the oils on anymore. I'll just go ahead and use the antibiotic and the cream. It'll clear it up. A week later, he still has this. And every time he'd stop using the cream, if he had forgot it in the morning or whatever, it would start to spread again. I said, baby, we've got to start putting that frankincense back on that place on your ear, because something's not working. We know that, because it's trying to spread still. It's still in your system and you're taking antibiotics. Something's happening here. And I was concerned that had turned into MRSA. So we put the frankincense on, and again, I mean, I got pictures, guys. If you want to see the pictures, you just tell me that you want to see the pictures. I will show you the difference between morning and evening, okay? Putting the frankincense on, immediately it stopped that staph infection from spreading. And where it had started to spread, where it had started to get red and not manifested any kind of a lesion, it backed off. You could literally see it back off. I mean, within 3 days of starting back with the essential oil, it was gone. And my husband is back to his regular routine. It's just another testimonial. Go to www.thingsinmyheadblog.com, because you're going to be able to get a special. We are going to have a link on our website. Paul is generous enough to be able to give us a special buy on some of his oils and to be able to link to his site directly from there. Even if you just want to try it, you need to go there. This man is an expert. He will give you all the information you need. They've got awesome customer service. They are a knowledgeable staff. Paul and his staff have done the research. They've done looking out at every angle that you could possibly look at for these essential oils, because it's essential to their health as well. Okay. These are people that use these oils. They live by these oils and they know how they work. I would trust an Indian medicine man every day of the week before I would go to a conventional doctor. They've been around a lot longer. Anyways, Paul, thank you so much for being with us. This has just been the most informative time. Hey, will you come back and talk to us some more?
I would love to, yes.
I am sure that my listeners are going to have questions. If you have questions about the essential oils that you need answered right away, you can either contact Paul directly on RockyMountainOils.com, or you can go to www.thingsinmyheadblog.com. You can also go to our Facebook page at facebook.com/thingsinmyheadblog. Okay, don't forget the blog on there. Go there, ask questions. We'll forward them to Paul. Not a problem. If you need to try the essential oils or even the defense, I would recommend to try the defense as well, RockyMountainOils.com, and buy them. They're not that expensive. You can get them in a 5-milliliter bottle and try them out. They're really not that expensive to do it that way. But let me tell you, you're going to be hooked. You're going to want to buy them in bigger quantities and more often. The rest of this month, we're going to be talking to some other experts about some other issues that you have: weight loss, blogging, getting back to family, getting back to church. We're going to be talking about all of that this month on Things in My Head blog and Things in My Head radio show. Again, Paul, thank you so much for being with us. God bless you. And we'll talk to you guys next week.